How can we be proactive in combating the current political rhetoric and the consequences of hate speech on the platform of mass media?
At the Huffington Post for the last year, I spearheaded a specific project, one that was personal to me. It was called the Islamophobia Tracker. And if you've ever seen the Islamophobia Tracker, we tracked across the country every act of vandalism, hate speech, racist policy, and of course the physical acts of aggression that we had that happened occurred to Muslims and people who just happened to look Muslim, right? So maybe not necessarily in the Muslim community. And for the entire year, we documented over 400 instances of just everyday occurrences of anti-Muslim rhetoric. And I know for the fact that number seems kind of low, and it probably is kind of low, because unfortunately there aren't any real information about Islamophobia here in the US. And so working on that project, it was very interesting, because on one side, I'm talking to the victims, I'm talking to people who have faced Islamophobia in one way or the other, and then after us developing this tracker, this amazing piece of information, the question now is, okay, how do we get this out? How do we tell people, like, look at all this horrible information, look at the facts, look at what the Muslim community is going through, and then maybe have them question their own values. So if someone who's kind of on the fence and feels uncomfortable with Muslims versus someone who's just a straight up bigot can maybe kind of reflect that information. And I was a bit naive thinking once we put this out that it was going to be receptive and people are going to really kind of open their minds a little bit. I didn't want them to change, but kind of just open their minds. And so the amount of hate and just horrible and awful comments that I had targeted at me from these people was just beyond me. Because my intention for this was something that was completely different, and I completely forgot the realities on the ground. The internet is a very toxic place to be, and I think sometimes we forget that. We understand how social media can be great. You want to interact with your family, you want to push out these articles that you feel like, you know, maybe I have a coworker on my Facebook that will see this and will understand it and, you know, can change some minds. But we also forget that it can also be a very harmful place. And I'm not even talking about the mental drain that we go through. I'm just talking about the comments, right? We're always told don't ever read the comments on any article. But there's a reason for that. People feel emboldened that they can say all these horrible things. And that's completely okay. And so one thing that I did personally, and it's a piece of advice that I give other people, is pick your battles. I know some of us feel the need that if we see a comment from an anonymous person who has a fake name, jack12345@hotmail.com, we just feel the need to respond to this person. My mother used to do this. My mom used to see something on Facebook and she'd be like, I need you to sign on Facebook right now and respond to this person. I'm like, who is this person? She's like, I don't know, but respond to this person. He's saying something terrible about Islam. I'm like, Mama, you don't even know who he is. And he could delete his account the next day. So understand that not everything has to be a fight, because there are some fights that we're not going to win. And on the internet, I would say the majority of the time, those are the fights that we're not going to win. So be able to give yourself that filter and step back and say, this is hate speech that's not going to change anyone's mind. It's not going to give me a sense of accomplishment. It's not going to change the ummah or the community for the better. And so I think being able to make that decision when to sign off and not respond to hateful speech online versus when to engage is a really fine line. And I think once we're able to develop a little bit more of a decision and clarity on that line, we will feel better, and then we can use our resources and our energy to actual things that matter, things off the internet, community organizing, talking to someone, talking to your neighbors, finding more interfaith work, because those are the things that actually yield results. It's easier than clicking like on something, because it's only going to take us going out and having conversations with hate speech with real people, because most of those people online that say something terrible, 90% of the time, they won't have that same gut to tell it to you in your face in person. So then why are we putting that same energy online?